Peace and love, strength and honor. Samir Saif representing Ontario Top Ten here at a Global Martial Arts Academy. Whoa. Let's cover the headbutt. Now, back in the day, early 90s, working at Tequila Willie's, I saw a very big security guard beside him. He was having a conversation. And, you know, he was full of vim and vigor, and I think he wanted to show us how it was done. And he went, boom, like this. And then he doubled down on it, and he went, boom, again. Don't really remember what happened to the other guy because I was so freaked out by what happened to him. The goose egg that went on his head and the self-imposed concussion that he gave himself, to this day, I remember. So my experience actually comes from all the combat sports I've been in. We work so hard in boxing, Muay Thai, kickboxing, MMA, like you name it, wrestling, to not headbutt each other. That's how many times the headbutt can be there. So like in wrestling, you know, sometimes you accidentally, when you're shooting down or coming underneath the underhook, you're using the same header area that you would in soccer, and you by accident, or you're coming up, or we're moving in boxing, and you go to hook them, and you headbutt, and you get called for it, and you can really, you know, knock someone out. So when you understand and have all that experience, you actually know how to put a good headbutt together. And the main way to make your headbutt successful is to understand it's not a wave of the cervical area. It's not like you're not snapping your neck. You're actually using posture, which I've taught you before. Nothing too crazy. And you just want to learn that when you drive your head, you lower yourself and you try to get the jaw. Stay away from the teeth. I've seen teeth embedded. I've been cut either coming underneath and heading them in the chin, or when you whack them, you're boom. You see how my spine is solid? I never break the neck this way. That's how you give yourself a concussion. And if you can hold onto them, I come low and I place it. But it's always in that this way where my neck and head come together. A great sport to see this is Lethwei. If you watch Lethwei, and I believe the champion's name is Dave LeDuc or LeDuc. Good stuff on headbutts. You can see how effective the headbutts are. But the main thing that you're going to see with these guys is that they move. When they come like this, boom, they move their body. I've had great success with headbutts. I haven't done a tremendous amount of headbutts in my lifetime. But the headbutts that I have pulled off, I've been fairly successful. Some as just stunners where we're in close, they're getting in my face, boom, and I just give them a nudge, oh, and they fall right into the elbow. Their problem, not my problem. So that's my take on the headbutt. If you like it, please comment. If you want to see certain things in our most marvelous self-defense series, let me know. Check me out on YouTube, subscribe, touch the notification bell, and let's grow this thing together. Peace and love, strength and honor. Samir Saif representing Ontario Top Team here at a Global Martial Arts Academy. Pow!